On the 4th of May 2020, Prophet Aaron Xhali proclaimed a word of prophecy concerning the nation of Nigeria. In this prophecy, the man of God urged believers worldwide to unite and pray for the country of Nigeria as he sees a devastating flood that is coming. This flood is going to destroy businesses and cause a setback in the lives of many Nigerians. This calls for all believers in Africa and the world at large to stand in the gap and pray for God's intervention upon this beloved nation. Let's listen to the words of the prophet regarding this prophecy.
Those all over the world, I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. I come before you tonight to present a message that the Lord of God for the nation Nigeria, for Africa. It has always been the nature of God to use men to speak to men. If you read the Bible throughout the entire history of the Bible, the Lord has always used men to speak to men. It is only those who have ears to listen and the wisdom to discern who will pay attention to what God is saying through his prophets. When you read in the book of 2 Kings chapter 7, it tells us that Elisha prophesied that the siege that was upon Samaria would be lifted. There were many men that doubted him. There were many men that opposed his prophecy simply because these people were not filled with the Spirit. These people did not understand the things of God. So I have received a message from the Lord. I personally respect Nigeria as my second spiritual home. And Nigeria have got many great men of God, many great prophets, which I respect so much. But the Lord have reached a stage where he's going to use the South to speak to the North and the North to speak to the South, vice versa. I've got a message. There is a flood that I see attacking the nation Nigeria. We as Africans, we as the people of the world, we need to be united in prayer. We need to be on our knees for the nation Nigeria. Nigeria is a nation that fears God. It's a nation that pay attention to God, a nation that yield to the Spirit of the Lord. Hence, we need to unite as Christians, as believers, to fast and pray for the nation Nigeria, because when this flood comes, it's going to disturb the way of life. It's going to destroy many businesses, and there's going to be setback in the lives of many people. As the Lord have said, this year 2020 is a year of great struggle. However, there's a blessing that the Lord have got in store for his people. So Nigerians, let us stand together. Africans, let us stand together and believe God and watch and pray. So let's take this moment and pray for the nation. Lord Jesus.
The prophecy came to pass just as the man of God had spoken. Indeed, there is a God in the heavens who reigns supreme above all things. Whatever that comes from his mouthpiece, Prophet Aaron Xhali, surely comes to pass in Jesus' name.
For living near a river. Farmlands and houses have been washed away and roads cut off. And Benue is just one of those affected states. The flooding has also hit Adamawa and Taraba, Kano, Bauchi, Jigawa, and Kaduna as well. The official death toll is around 140 so far. but aid agencies fear that will rise as disease takes hold. Thousands have taken shelter where they can. Here, primary schools are now camps for the internally displaced.
We have over 10,000 people. Let's say in this camp we should have about 6 or 7,000, another camp, maybe 4 or 5,000, another camp too. And the population of IDPs keep increasing because the level of the water keep increasing by day.
The agency reckons many here should not return home and must instead move off the floodplain, adding that thousands more should also be evacuated. Aduria Chumba, Lagos, Nigeria.
My people. This is Lekki Abraham Adesanya. As you can see, it's no joke. Those of you going to work, coming back, be ready for war. This is what we call war at Abraham Adesanya. My people. Hey!
Daniel Abe, check your message.
Oh boy.